after over a year of waiting, I'm finally giving a tutorial on how, well, not necessarily a tutorial, but a kind of breakdown, I'll make own of the glob glow gab glab thing. There is many steps in the process, but the main focus here is Blender. This is a free 3D editing modeling stuff software. Now, my workflow would be much simpler nowadays because I found out much simpler methods. To be a just filter, I can just make my own in Blender nodes. I can apply them at render time. There it is. Alright, this file here. Glowgab.blend. I don't know what this beginning is. I don't know what's going on here. What happened to the file? Okay, well, so the bookshelves I have modeled with very, very neon colors, just like in the actual game. Wow, it's really low poly. It's like it was actually on a PS1. Although, this is way too many polygons for the PS1 to render, as far as I know. But yeah, as you see, I didn't finish the animations. I really just wanted to get this out before someone else made it, to be honest. There's probably the chance someone would have made it. So let's look at how I animated this. I definitely used F-curves, I'm pretty sure. Let me look at this bone action. F-curves. Oh, no! No! That wasn't supposed to happen! Oh, apparently I did not use F-curves, or did I? No, I didn't, actually. Wow. Same method. I just rendered all this in Blender. Like, there's a just render image here. Check it out. There's this little nice, this 272 pixel image. No anti-aliasing. It's perfect for the, PlayStation. I could not get the affine mapping. I really wish I could. That would enhance the experience. This, I just drew this in paint.net. Like, this is the raw texture. Oh, that's not the raw texture. This is the raw texture. I wish that were me right there. I mean, what? T-pose. Check that out. Oh, it's hot. This one's an actual RIP model. And now, for the rest of the editing, here's what I did. So, I rendered the whole thing in Premiere, and I just exported as an AVI. Then I went to Virtual Dub. Right here. This program. And I applied an AVI Synth VHS filter by Yuki Menu Star. I'm gonna look for that filter again. So here's what I did. This little blue.api here. This is the original file I put into the thing.
Double shibble shibble glibble swap glab.
Oh. I am the glob glow gab glab. The swabble double wab.
Yeah. There's blue.new.api. I think this was the second AVI I exported. Just to make it smaller. So, what I did is I went into this AVI synth filter and I set the file to be bloob new. Save that and I dragged this into here and it loads up the thing.
I'm full of
it's not a real time filter at all, but it's kind of accurate. So use this. Tribal Devil Glibber Glabber Silver Shop Glab. That stuff. Yeah, here's a sample that came with the thing. Meow 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 meow. Should I make a few more filters? My next thing is the other thing. The little overlay you saw there. How did I make that? Well, you see, yeah, this. There's this magic called Adobe Animate. I open up dab.flaw. I call it that because the glob glob gab glab said, dab. Synced up to the audio track. He stays on good the whole time. The score doesn't go up. That shows how early the prototype is. Or really just, I was just too lazy to finish it, really. Although, I just mainly had no way. I don't have the font or anything. Why? I'm lazy. I didn't feel like going to Spriter's Resort. Okay. Yeah, I didn't feel like going to Spriter's Resort. So look at the little Glub Glub Gab Glab head just passing along right here. Bruh. Look at this beauty. I, of course, used Comic Sans. I don't have the font. Actually, I think this is Comic New. No, that's Comic Sans. Sans, though. That's really mostly all there is to it. I composite this onto in Adobe Premiere. That's it. Really. Just put the link to the Yuki menu sort of thing in the description. But not now, I don't even have internet, I don't have the connected data, and I'm not going to do that to upload a 1080p 60 frames a second video. So yeah, that's it. Peace out. Bye.